Eleanor Windman last updated 1305, September 21, 2017. Properties in Ward were badly damaged by the Cape Mira earthquake in November last year. File pic: Tosca Bailey is in the lucky half of Upper South Island homeowners. 10 months after the Cape Mira earthquake, Bailey's insurance claim for her Ward home is finally done and dusted. "We only just settled last week. It has taken a while, even though we were priority," she said. Contractors patched the roof of the Blenheim Club after the November earthquake damaged its chimney. File pic: Bailey's elderly father had recently moved back in with her family, making their case more urgent. Read more: insurance claims total $1.84 billion for Kakara earthquake. Earthquake damage to Marlborough wine industry likely to top $100 million. Damaged Kakara businesses in limbo post-quake as insurers struggle be in the know. See your earthquake claim go smoothly November 24. "That's when we thought we had it assessed," Bailey said. She said someone came out to look at their home at that time, 10 days after the 7.8 magnitude quake, but no report was passed on to their insurance company. Bailey waited another 5 months for her place to be reassessed in April this year. According to the Insurance Council of New Zealand (ICNZ), the time between assessment and settlement was typically between 4 and 12 weeks. Bailey was one of more than 10,000 people in the Upper South Island, north of Waimakariri River, who lodged a residential claim following the Cape Mira earthquake. The Insurance Council reported 52%, or 55-15, had been fully or partly settled by the end of August. "Most of the people I know haven't been settled yet," Bailey said. Ward resident Steffi Elliott had her family home assessed at the start of the year. "It was all go, go, go. At one stage, we had three people turn up. Since then, she's heard nothing. There's been no communication." Her main concern was around the septic tanks on her property. The land gradient had shifted slightly after the earthquake, and when it's rained, the tank overflowed. "It's only a slight change in the gradient, but it's enough to keep water running off back into the septic tank. It's annoying. You can't flush the toilets when it's raining, because the water's coming up the pipe." In the area north of Waimakariri River, Insurance Council figures showed private insurers had assessed 92% of residential claims. Council Chief Executive Tim Grafton said progress was being made with residential claims. "We said we would have the majority of Cape Mira earthquake settlement offers made by year-end. We are over halfway and ahead of expectations," he said. "We are pleased with our steady rate of progress and continue to have a high level of confidence that the majority of people will have received settlement offers by the end of the year," he said. Nationwide, he said 77% of all residential buildings had been assessed. Stuff.